Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. My dear students, yesterday we are discussing success of Bohr's theory and limitations of Bohr's theory. In the success of Bohr's theory, we discussed one formula, energy of nth orbit of hydrogen atom. Yesterday I have forgotten to write the symbol minus. So please consider me. The exact formula is En, that is energy of nth orbit of hydrogen atom. The formula is minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. Please mention here, minus symbol is there. Please mention here, minus symbol is there. En is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. So this is the formula. Please make a correction in the yesterday's notes. Energy of nth orbit, En is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. Yes, we are going to solve two problems regarding the formulas. Yes, on the screen you can see the question. Problem number 2.10. Problem number 2.10. Yes, you can see the question. Problem number 2.10. If you are not having the textbook, please note down in your running notes. Please note down the problem in your running notes. Of course, this model is important for JEE. This model is important for JEE, Joint Entrance Examination, JEE. That is an entrance examination for NITs, National Institute of Technologies. If you qualify in that one, you can also attempt JEE Advance, JEE Advance. That is the entrance examination for IITs and IIITs and IITs and IIITs. Anyhow, once again the question, what are the frequency and wavelength of a photon emitted during a transition from n is equal to phi to n is equal to 2 in the hydrogen atom? N is equal to 5 indicating higher energy state. N is equal to 5 indicating higher energy state. N is equal to 2 indicating lower energy state. Here, what is happening means an excited electron is going to get de-excites. An excited electron is going to get de-excite. So whenever de-excitation is going to happen, some amount of energy will be emitted. And the energy emitted will be in the form of electromagnetic radiations. And the electromagnetic radiations are having wave number, wavelength, and frequency. So we are going to calculate frequency and wavelength of photons emitted. So to calculate the frequency or wavelength, first we have to calculate the energy difference between the two orbits. Energy difference between the two orbits, that is delta E. Delta E. So first we are going to calculate delta E value. We have to calculate the delta E value. Delta E is equal to EF minus EI. F means final. Final means higher energy state. I means initial. Initial means lower energy state. So to calculate the wavelength, and the frequency, first we are going to calculate difference between the energies of the two orbits. What are the two orbits given? Fifth orbit is given and the second orbit is given. So according to the formula, En is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. If n is replaced with 5, then we can write E5 is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by 5 square joules. That is the energy of fifth orbit. Like that, energy of second orbit is equal to same, minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by, here n value is replaced with 2. Then we can write 1 by 2 square joules. So finally we can say that energy of fifth orbit and energy of second orbit. Energy of fifth orbit is taken as EF, that is the final higher energy state, and EI is taken as E2, that means lower energy state. Then we are going to calculate delta E. So with the help of delta E, we can calculate frequency and wavelength. So first we are going to calculate delta E value, difference in the energies of the two orbits. That is also known as the amount of energy emitted. The amount of energy emitted we are going to calculate by using the formula delta E is equal to E5 minus E2. Right, what is the E5 value? What is the E5 value? Minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by 5 square. This is the E5 value. Minus yes, E2 value. What is the E2 value? Minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by 2 square. This is the E2 value. In the E5 and E2, one thing is common. What is common? Minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 is common. So by taking the common, then we can write it as 1 by 5 square minus 1 by 2 square. Right? Now, simplification. The simplification is minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by 25 minus 1 by 4. Yes, by taking the simplification, then we can write the delta E as minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into, here LCM is 100, 25 fourths, 4 into 1, 4. So here the answer is 4 minus 4 25s, 25 into 1, 25. So that is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 4 minus 25. Minus 21 by 100. So final calculation, delta E is equal to, here minus is there, here minus is there. Both are multiplying with each other. Minus into minus plus. Now, do the calculation and text me the answer. Do the calculation and text me the answer. What will be the delta E value? What will be the delta E value? 2.18 multiplied with 21. 2.18 multiplied with 21. The value is 45.78 into 10 to the power of minus 18. Here, 100 is there in the denominator. That is 10 square. If it is written in the numerator, 10 power minus 2. So final simplification. What is the final simplification value? Delta E is equal to 45.78 into 10 to the power of minus 20 joules. Otherwise, we can write in 4.578 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. So this is the energy difference between the fifth orbit to second orbit. The energy difference between the fifth orbit to second orbit, this amount of energy is going to get emit. This amount of energy is going to get emit when electron is going to get a de-excite from fifth level to second level. So during the emission, this is the energy called as, this is the energy called as emitted radiations. According to Planck's quantum theory, according to the Planck's quantum theory, the energy is going to be emitted in the form of small, the energy is going to be emitted in the form of small pockets. They are called as photons. Photons are quanta. So here photons are going to be emitted. That emitted photons are in the form of electromagnetic radiations. Now we can say that electromagnetic radiations are going to have frequency, wave number and wavelength. So with the help of this value, we are going to calculate frequency and wavelength. Right, now we are going to calculate frequency and wavelength by using the amount of energy emitted. By using the amount of energy emitted, we are going to calculate the frequency and wavelength. According to Niels Bohr, what is the formula of Bohr's frequency rule? 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 Can anybody say? My dear students, it is not minus 4.58. It is not minus 4.58 because the amount of energy emitted, that is 4.587 into 10 to the power of minus 19. What is the formula of Bohr's frequency rule? Yes, Bohr's frequency rule formula is Bohr's frequency rule. What is the formula of Bohr's frequency rule? Nu is equal to Bohr's frequency of emitted radiation. Nu is equal to delta E by H. Once again, the Bohr's frequency rule is nu is equal to delta E by H. Delta E value, 4.578 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules by H value, 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second. H means Planck's constant. The Planck's constant value is 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second. So in the denominator, units are joules a second. In the numerator, the units are joules. So joules get cancelled. Finally, in the denominator, seconds are there. That goes to the numerator, becomes as second inverse. Second inverse. Second inverse is nothing but hedges. So what is the unit of frequency? The unit of frequency is second inverse or hedges. Then we can calculate it. Yes, text me the answer. 4.578 divided with 6.6256. 4.578 divided with 6.6256. The answer is 0.691 into 10 to the power of minus 19 is there. 10 to the power of minus 19. Into 10 to the power of 34. That is 10 to the power of 15. 10 to the power of 15 second inverse. Otherwise, we can write it as 6.91 into 10 to the power of 14 second inverse. Here, second inverse is also replaced. The second inverse is also replaced with Hedges in the name of scientist Henry Hedge. In the name of scientist Henry Hedge, second inverse is replaced with Hedges. The symbol of Hedges is Hz. So, what is the frequency of emitted photons? What is the frequency of emitted photons? The frequency of emitted photons is nu is equal to 6.91 into 10 to the power of 14 Hedges. So, we are calculated the frequency with the help of amount of energy emitted. Amount of energy emitted. My dear students, please tell me whether energy is a negative value or positive value. Whether energy is a negative value or positive value. Suppose if you eat any chocolate, on the chocolate you can see some calories are there. Calories, maybe 10 calories or 15 calories, like that. If you eat any biscuit or if you take any food, for example, rice or chicken, biryani, anything, whatever it may be, we are taking the food that is containing some calories, nothing but energy. Energy is always having which type of sign? Positive sign. Positive sign. Right, all of you correct. Positive sign. But you are getting some doubt. Actually, the formula I written is, actually, I have not written the formula. Niels Bohr said that one. En is equal to, what is the formula of En? Once text me, what is the formula of En? Once text me the formula, what is the formula of En? What is the formula of En? Very good, correct. Minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. According to Niels Bohr, the energy of nth orbit is given as -2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square joules. Now you will get a doubt. Sir, already you said that energy is never going to be negative. I said that energy is never going to be negative. But Niels Bohr is saying that in the formula of energy, what is there? Negative sign is there. What the negative sign is indicating? What this negative sign is indicating? Here the negative sign is indicating when the electron is going to be attracted towards the nucleus from the infinity distance. When an electron is going to be attracted into the atom from the infinity distance, to indicate that one, that negative sign is used by Niels Bohr. Just the negative sign is indicating the electron is going to be coming into the atom from the infinity distance from the atom. That is the sign, negative sign. So generally we know that energy is always a positive value. That's why here, if you say this answer, delta E, delta E is also having positive value, not the negative value, because some amount of energy is going to get emitted. So always the amount of energy emitted is going to be positive value, right? So no need to confuse. So delta E is equal to 4.578 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. And this is the amount of energy emitted, that is the emitted radiations, and the emitted radiations, nothing but they are the photons emitted. That photons emitted are in the form of electromagnetic radiations. That electromagnetic radiations are having frequency, and the frequency is calculated by the formula Bohr's frequency rule, nu is equal to delta E by H. Yes, now text me. Are you understood or not? Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt? Okay, fine. Very good. Very good. Now, coming to the point. So, this is the calculation of frequency. So, from this frequency, now we are going to calculate wavelength. From the value of frequency, frequency value is obtained as 6.91 into 10 to the power of 14 Hedges. From this frequency value, we are going to calculate wavelength of emitted photons. wavelength of emitted photons. Wavelength of emitted photons. Wavelength. What is the symbol of wavelength? What is the symbol of wavelength? Wavelength symbol is lambda. Of course, all of you know frequency formula. What is the formula of frequency? What is the formula of frequency? Not according to Niels Bohr. Yes, very good. C by lambda. Frequency formula is the general formula of frequency. Nu is equal to C by lambda. Now I am going to calculate lambda. Lambda is equal to, what is the formula of lambda? Lambda is equal to C by nu. C by nu. Yes. What is meant by C? C means speed of light. Speed of light. Speed of light value. 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. 3 × 10⁸ meters per second by frequency value. How much value is obtained? 6.91 frequency. Yes, my dear students, please text me how much value of frequency is obtained. 6.91 × text me your answer. What is the frequency obtained? Very good, correct. 6.91 × 10⁴ second inverse, that is the frequency. Now second inverse gets cancelled. Now the calculation, lambda is equal to wavelength of emitted photons. Lambda is equal to 3 divided with 6.91. The answer is 0.434 × 10⁻². What is the 10⁻⁴? 10⁸ minus 10⁴. That is equal to 10⁻⁶. And the units are meters. This is the decimal. If this decimal is moved to the right side, one time, second time, third time. If the decimal is moved to the right side 3 times, 10⁻⁷ get decreases 3 times. Then we can write it as lambda is equal to 434 × 10⁻⁹ meters. 10⁻⁹ meters means nanometers, nm. 10⁻⁹ meters means nanometers. So finally, we will replace 10⁻⁹ with nano. 10⁻⁹ is called as nano. So simply, I can write it as 434 nanometers. So this is the wavelength of emitted photons. Nearest answer. I'm doing calculation with the help of my mobile. If you do the calculation with the help of a logarithm book, the answer will be little bit variation. So lambda is equal to 434 nanometers. I done the calculation with the help of my mobile. Once again, I'm going to check it. Yes, is it okay? Okay, fine. So, my dear students, here it is not about the calculations first. First, you have to understand the concept. What was given in the problem? What is the data given in the problem? What we have to calculate? How to use the logarithm book? When you are coming to the college, we will discuss how to use the logarithm book. All the students are requested, please try to purchase the logarithm books. Whenever you are coming to the offline classes, in the classrooms, we have to discuss. Because in the online, it is not easy to discuss the logarithms. And it is not scheduled also. Within the 10th class, you have to learn. Because mathematics, logarithm belongs to mathematics. You have to learn from your mathematics lecturers. Or mathematics teachers. Of course, I will explain the logarithm book but after coming to the classrooms. Anyhow, just now we are doing the calculations with the help of only mobile, but in the examinations the mobiles will not be allowed. All of you know that one. So this is all about the first problem. And coming to the next problem, see the next problem in the textbook. Problem number 2.11. On the screen you can see the problem. Problem number 2.11. Just by using your two fingers on the screen, you can enlarge the screen size. You can see the question very clearly with larger text. Just by using your two fingers on the screen, just enlarge that one. Just zoom it. You can see the problem very clearly like this. You can see the problem very clearly like this if you zoom it. Right? So please read the question first. Read the question. Please read the question. On the screen, it is shared or not? Sorry, my dear students, just a minute. Is it shared or not? Is the question shared to you or not? Okay, fine. Thank you. Right, I'm going to explain that one. Yes, once again, I'm reading the question. Calculate the energy associated with the first orbit of helium ion. Calculate the energy associated with the first orbit of helium ion. What is the radius of this orbit? What is the radius of this orbit? Yes, tell me, helium ion. Whether helium ion is having one electron or two electrons? Whether helium ion is having one electron or two electrons? Helium ion, He plus, whether it is having one electron or two electrons? He plus is having one electron or two electrons. That means you didn't understood yesterday's class. Yoga Venkata Prasad, you are correct. You are correct. Helium ion is having only one electron. Abdul Qadir, correct. So helium ion is having one electron. I'm going to come to the board. So first of all, I'm taking the helium ion. All of you know helium, He. Atomic number is 2. Atomic number 2 means that contain two electrons. Atomic number is equal to the number of electrons. Once again, atomic number is equal to the number of electrons. So helium is the atom, atomic number 2, that contain two electrons. When helium ion is taken, it is going to lose one electron. Then helium ion is going to contain one electron. Hydrogen atom is going to contain one electron. So helium ion is an example of hydrogen-like species. Once again, helium ion is an example of hydrogen-like species because hydrogen is having one electron. Helium ion is also having one electron. Then we can say that helium ion is known as hydrogen-like species. In the case of hydrogen-like species, what is the formula used to calculate radius of the orbit? What is the formula used to calculate radius of orbit? The radius of orbit is equal to 52.9 picometers into 1 by n square into 1 by z. Yesterday we discussed this formula. Radius of nth orbit of hydrogen like species. Radius of nth orbit of hydrogen like species Rn is equal to 52.9 picometers into 1 by n square into 1 by z. That is equal to 52.9 picometers into helium ion. Helium ion is going to contain one electron. One electron is present in which orbit? One electron is present in first orbit. First orbit means n value is taken as 1. That is 1 by 1 square into helium. Atomic number is 2. Atomic number is 2. That is 1 by z is. Z means atomic number. That is equal to 2. Then that is equal to 52.9 picometers divided with 2. That is equal to 26.45 picometers. 26.45. Is it correct? Once check the calculation. 52.9 divided with 2. Yes, 26.45 picometers. My dear students, here we are calculated the radius of nth orbit of helium ion or the radius of first orbit of helium ion. The radius of first orbit of helium ion represented as R1He plus radius of first orbit of helium ion, and it is calculated as 26.45 picometers. What is meant by pico? What is meant by pico? Pico means 10 to the power of minus 12. 10 to the power of minus 12. Then we will write it as 26.45 into 10 to the power of minus 12 meters. Then you can convert this value into angstroms. You can also convert this value into nanometers. You can also convert this value into centimeters. So in the CET level, direct answer will not be given. Conversions will be given. Actually, we are getting the answer in picometers. We have to convert it into either angstroms or in nanometers. Later, you have to try and text me the answers. So that is all about the radius of first orbit of helium ion. Now, energy. Energy of nth orbit. Energy of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species. What is the formula? The energy of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species. Formula. Minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square into z square joules. Once again, energy of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species. Energy of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species, En, is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by n square into z square joules. Here the unit is joules. And helium ion is given. Helium ion means n value is 1, z value is 2. Then energy of first orbit of helium ion is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by, just tell me, 1 by? 1 by? Can anybody guess? Yes, 1 by 1 square. 1 by 1 square into 2 square. Because Z means atomic number. We are taking the helium. Atomic number of helium is 2. Then here we have to write 2 square joules. So the simplification, energy of first orbit of helium ion is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 4 joules. Yes, what is the answer? 2.18 multiplied with 4. 2.18 multiplied with 4. That is E, that is energy of first orbit of helium ion is equal to minus 8.72 into 10 to the power of minus 18 joules. So this is the answer. Yes, my dear students, please text me whether the body is clearly visible to you. Whether the body is clearly visible to you. Is the writing size, font size, is the font size is clear? Is the font size is clear? Whether I had to increase the font? Whether I had to increase the font or the font size is clear? Okay, fine. So this is all about success of Bohr's theory. So with the help of Bohr's atomic model, we can calculate what we can calculate? We can calculate radius of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species, and we can also calculate energy of nth orbit of hydrogen-like species. This is the advantage of Niels Bohr's model of atom. Of course, this theory is having the drawbacks, limitations. So, next atomic theory was proposed. That is the quantum mechanical model of atom. Next theory is quantum mechanical model of atom. So the next atomic theory going to be discussed is quantum mechanical model of atom. The quantum mechanical model of atom is depending upon two concepts. The first concept is dual nature of matter. The first concept is the dual nature of matter, and the second concept is Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Heisenberg uncertainty principle. In the next class, we will discuss these two concepts. So with the